Hello and welcome to another Swift and Xcode tutorial. My name's Cal and in today's tutorial we're going to be building a very simple calendar view. In the first part of the tutorial we're just going to get the layout sorted. We're going to use buttons and stack views as well as component view to create the actual days of the calendar. We're going to create a calendar helper file with some basic calendar methods that hopefully are reusable that we can use throughout our app just to make the calendar a little bit easier to work with. And then yeah, in the final part we're just going to tie it all together. Creating a new Xcode project. This is an app. I'm going to call it Calendar Example Tutorial. Storyboard, UIKit, and Swift is our programming language. And then we're just going to head into the main storyboard. I'm going to drag in a label at the top and just center it in the middle and give it a little bit of space to the top. This label is going to display our calendar's month and year. So I'm just making that a little bit bigger and bold. And then I'm going to drag in two buttons. The first one, I'm just going to say horizontal spacing to the label, as well as trailing space to the edge. I'm going to center it vertically off our label, leading space 0 and align space 0. Just going to remove the button title and add in an image. I'm just typing in right and I'm going to select arrow shape turn right. System default image, so it should be available to you, but it's not really important what the button is. It's just one that I like the look of. So just doing the same thing on the other side, centering the button vertically off the label, making sure all of those constraints are 0. So we've just got one nice label in the middle and then two buttons on either side. Flipping the arrow, so we've got a left turn arrow and a right turn arrow, proportional height equal to 1. So the buttons are the exact same height as the calendar month label. And then we're going to drag in a stack view. So make sure this is a horizontal stack view. Sit that just below our month and year label. It is going to contain the day of the week, so Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, etc. Basically giving it trailing space and leading space to the edge. Center it horizontally in the safe area, as well as giving it a height and top space to the month label. And once we adjust all of those constraints, it should just be sitting just below our month label and buttons. And so inside our stack view, I'm just going to drag in a label, adjusting the text to be Sunday. I'm going to make the text a little bigger, as well as making it align in the center. I'm going to change the color to dark gray, and then I'm just going to copy and paste that 6 more times. For each day of the week, so Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, Saturday, Sunday. Cool, and then with our stack view, we just need to make it so that it fills equally, so each one of the days of the week is takes up the exact same amount of space horizontally. It's under stack view distribution, fill equally. Final component for our calendar tutorial example is a collection view. So I'm just dragging that in. I'm going to give it vertical spacing to the stack view, as well as bottom, trailing, and leading space to the container, setting all of those constraints to 0 so that basically the collection view takes up the rest of the available space. And then I'm just going to drag a label onto our collection view cell, and I'm going to center it horizontally and vertically in the container, and then just change the multiplier of vertical constraint to be 0.5, just so it sits a little bit higher in the cell. And then I'm going to adjust the size and the font. I'm going to make it bold. So we're going to create the file for our calendar cell. So we're just saying file, new Swift file, and I'm going to call it calendar cell. A class calendar cell, which is of type UI. I just need to import the UI kit, UI collection view cell. And then if we click onto our collection view cell and we head into here and we say class calendar cell, it should be linked up now. So we've linked the Swift file with the storyboard cell. And next, we're just going to open up the assistant editor, and I'm just going to create an outlet for the collection view as well as our month label. We're going to create two button actions, next and previous month. So just right click and drag, calling this one previous month, and doing the same thing, calling it next month. And then we're going to head into our calendar cell, and for some reason it wasn't working for me with the assistant editor. I've just pasted in a outlet for a label, and then now I can select it in the assistant editor and link up our label with our cells label. Cool, so that's most of our calendar's layout finished. So we can close off the assistant editor and head into our viewcontroller.swift file. And I'm just going to do a quick bit of tidying up, getting rid of the comments. And then the first thing we're going to do is declare a variable. I'm going to call it selected date, which is equal to date, which is just putting today's date into that variable. And then we're going to create another variable. We're going to call it total squares, which is an array of strings. And then we're going to create a function calling it set cells view. And we're going to call that from viewDidLoad. And inside here, we're just going to say let width equal to collectionView.frame.size.width minus 2. So that's our padding divided by 8. So we get 8 because there are 7 days in a week. And then we just need to add 1. And 2 is a bit of an arbitrary number, but it's the spacing around each of the cells. So we're just going to copy and paste down that line and changing the variable name as well as the frame size to height. We're going to leave the padding as 2. And we're going to keep it as divided by 8. So we're going to have 7 rows. We're never going to fill the bottom one. You could change that to 7 if you wanted the calendar to take up a bit more of the screen. let flow layout equal to collectionView.collectionViewLayout as collectionViewFlowLayout, and then say flow layout item size is equal to new CG size and give it our width and our height. Next, we want to get our calendar collection view linked with our view controller. So I'm just going to head right up to the top. I'm going to put in a comma and then I'm going to type UI collection view delegate and then another comma and UI collection view data source. And then it's going to give us an error message saying we need to implement those functions. So I'm just going to hit fix and implement the protocol stubs. For the number of items in section method, we're just going to return total squares.count. For the cell for item at method, we're going to say let cell equal to collectionView.dq reusable cell with reuse identifier. So you just couldn't put whatever you like in here. So I've called it cal cell. For index path as calendar cell, which is our class that we created earlier. And then we're going to say cell.dayofmonth.text is equal to total squares, get the string out of our total squares array at indexPath.item, and then just return the cell. We're going to copy the cal cell or whatever you've used as a reuse identifier and head into the main storyboard, click on the cell and put it in as an identifier. So those two strings have to match for it to link up correctly. And then I'm just going to right click from our collection view onto our view controller and assign it to be a delegate and a data source. And you can check by just right clicking on your collection view. Nice one. So next what we're going to do is create another Swift file, and I'm going to call this calendarhelper.swift. And basically this is just going to be somewhere to put all of our various calendar methods. I'm just defining a new class, somewhere to put all these methods. I'm calling it calendarhelper. And the first thing I'm going to do is declare a variable called calendar, and it's just going to be equal to calendar.current. And then I'm going to create another function below that. It's going to be plus month. And it's going to take a date and return a date. And we're just going to say calendar.date by adding month to date, the value of one. Given any date, add exactly 1 month. So given a date in January, it'll return a date in February. And given a date in February, it'll return a date in March. And we just need to make that non-optional. And then we're going to copy and paste that down and just renaming the method to minus month and changing the value to minus one. So just the same thing in reverse. The next method we're going to create is called month string, and it's also going to take a date and it's going to return a string though. And all we need to do in here is just say let date formatter equal to date formatter, and we're going to set the date formatter LLLLL. And so this is just going to return a month in text, and then return date formatter.string from date. Copy and paste that method down for year and just change the date formatter to four Y's. And that's going to return just the year as a number. So the next method we're going to create is called days in month, and it's just going to return the number of days in any given month. So for example, January has 31 days, whereas April has 30 days. Given a date in January, it's going to return 31. Whereas if it's given a date in April, it will return 30. So we're just going to say range is equal to calendar.range of day in month for date, and then just return range.count. Our next calendar method is day of month. So just take the day component out of any given month. So just going to say calendar.dateComponentsDay from date, and then return components.day. Given the 2nd of January 2020, it will just return 2. The next method is 1st of month. It's going to have the same parameters, but rather than pulling out the day, we're actually going to pull out the year and month, and that's going to give us the 1st of. So given the 15th of January, our 1st of month function is going to return the 1st of January. Cool. And the next function we're going to create, we're going to call it weekday. So I've just copy and pasted from the day of month function, and I'm just going to change that to weekday and weekday. And then we're actually going to minus one. Cool. And that should be all of our basic functions created in our calendar helper Swift file. So heading back into our main view controller, we're going to create a new function calling it set month view. And first thing we're going to do is just remove all from our total squares string array. And then we're going to define a days in month variable. And we're just going to call our calendar helper and get our days in month from our selected date. So remember that selected date was just initialized to today's date. And then we're going to say let first day of month equal to calendar helper first day of month, and giving it our selected date as well. And then we're going to say let starting spaces equal to calendar helper weekday, giving it the first of the month. Next, we're going to declare a variable called count and just initialize it to one. And then we're going to say while count is less than 42, and 42 is the number of squares we're going to populate. So 31 days is the maximum in a month, but first of the month falls on a Saturday. We're going to need at least 6 rows to fill in all the days, and obviously 6 times 7 is 42. And then we're just going to say if count is less than or equal to starting spaces, so how many blank spaces before the first of the month, or count minus starting spaces is greater than days in month, however many squares are left over to fill in our 6th row, we're going to append a empty string. Otherwise, we're going to append string value of count minus starting spaces. So move along, say, 6 places, and then put in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 until we get to the end of the month, and then start putting in blank spaces again to fill in 6 rows. And then we're just going to say count plus equal to 1, and we need to call this function from our viewDidLoad just so that we put in the initial month on load. And then we're also going to put it in previous month, But before we do that, we're going to say selected date is equal to calendar helper dot minus a month from selected date, and then call set month view. And we just need to do the exact same thing for next month, but just calling plus month instead of minus month. Really quick, I'm just going to override the should auto rotate, and I'm just going to return false so the screen won't rotate. So the last thing we need to do is just head up and set our month label. So we're just going to call our calendar helper and get our nicely formatted month string plus a little bit of space, and then get our nicely formatted year string given our selected date. And then we're just going to say collection view, reload data. Cool. And heading back into the storyboard, there's one thing I forgot to do, which was actually set our padding. We've already set our padding to 2, if you can remember right at the start of the video, but we didn't do it here in the storyboard. So min spacing to 2 for lines and for cells. And if we go and run this, you can see we've got a pretty sweet looking calendar view in Swift and Xcode. You can scroll through and all of the dates should be filling in correctly. But yeah, that's a pretty basic calendar view. I feel like I could continue on with this project. If anybody's interested, maybe we could do something with selected date, like put in an event or something along that line. So yeah, if you want me to continue on with this tutorial, just leave a comment below with some suggestions, and maybe I'll have to make a follow-up video for this one. But otherwise, yeah, if you like the video, give it a like, and I'll catch you guys in the next tutorial. Cheers.